We're starting today at a very snowy soccer field. Yeah. This guy is crazy, but very dedicated. So the main reason, at least I think, that you come to Steamboat Springs is for the hot springs. The one that you pay a lot of money to go into and it's really nice is like a 2-hour wait. So we found some natural ones and we're just gonna check them out and see how this is gonna go.
Oh, it's freezing.
Really?
It's freezing right here. How is that cold? Bubbling right
yeah,
over
why
there.
Why is it bubbling?
It's bubbling right there and it's cold.
Is it active?
Well, yeah, it's legit cold. Yeah, touch it.
Ugh.
We're waiting in line to go to the hot springs. So, because my expectations were severely undermet with that 68 degree hot spring, we are going to pay the arm and a leg for the actual hot springs and have a good time. Today is day 224, and we're covering Lamentations 1 through chapter 3, verse 36. You know, much like my expectations not being met earlier today with that, like, natural outdoor hot spring, I feel like that was the same thing that happened for me today when it came to the book of Lamentations. I had a certain expectation of how I thought the book, or at least the first half of the book was gonna go, but it actually exceeded my expectations.
What? Oh yeah?
Those hot springs were so nice. And like I was saying, my expectations of the natural hot springs that we came across earlier, they were severely undermet. And the reason why my expectations weren't quite met in terms of our reading today was because I was expecting from the first half of Lamentations to be a lot of just doom and gloom and destruction, and we see that in there, but we also see God speaking through the prophet Jeremiah in this Lamentation of his goodness to his people, and how even the aspect of God's sovereignty and his control and his majesty is driven by his consistent love for his people. And this is tough to understand here, but because we could ask, well, why? How could God be so loving when you see all this destruction and wrath come upon his people and all the other nations? And we face that question sometimes. Like, how could a loving God allow such evil? And it's not a question of how could God, but as we read Lamentations, it's a question of how could we? We have to remember that God is doing all of this because of his people's sin, their sinfulness. He had been very patient with them. He had tarried long with them for them to return and to come to him, but yet they still did not follow him. And because of that, there needed to be a payment for that sin, and that's why God brought his wrath. But even in the midst of it, he brought his wrath in such a way as to help his people turn to him and to show them how much he cares about them and how much he wants them. Like he's a jealous God. And we really have to see it through that lens of that God, whether it's in his wrath or it's in his grace and mercy, he's always operating out of his steadfast love, not just for his chosen people, but for all of humanity.